Good morning, I'm Tim Archer, and we're still reading through the Bible. TimothyArcher.com/kitchen is where you'll find everything. I'm sorry TimothyArcher.com doesn't take you there anymore. I still haven't figured that one out. I'll try and work on it. You can download a calendar there, you can see the readings there, or you can just follow along with the devotionals. I'll try and indicate where we are. Today we're reading in Nahum. I don't know how to pronounce it right, so that's probably wrong. But Nahum talks about Nineveh, the capital city of Assyria, just like Jonah did, that we read on Friday. Now, on Friday, we saw that Jonah was sent to Nineveh, didn't want to go to Nineveh, because he knew that God is a forgiving God. He wasn't scared of the Assyrians. He was scared of God's grace. He was scared that God was going to forgive the Assyrians after Jonah announced destruction. And guess what? That's what happened. Because that's our God. He is slow to anger and quick to forgive, exactly like Jonah says. But then we read Nahum and we see that, well, God's patience has come to an end. It's 100 years later. Okay, they've had 100 years of forgiveness, of grace, of tolerance, and God says no more. Your cruelty continues, your injustice continues, your sin continues, Nineveh is going to be destroyed. Because one constant message in the prophets is that each generation pays its own sins. It's not about one generation paying for what a previous generation did, nor a generation being saved because of what a previous generation did. Each will be judged according to their own deeds, just like us. I'm not saved because my dad was good and my son won't be condemned if I'm bad. Each will pay for their own sin. That's how it works. And so Nineveh, with its cruelty and arrogance and general injustice, is going to be destroyed and was destroyed. We know that from history. So we get the two sides of God's justice. We see his forgiveness and his grace and his hesitance to punish, but his willingness to punish when it's necessary. God will punish sin. Let's pray. Father God, help us to renounce sin and to seek righteousness. Help us to rejoice in your grace, but not abuse your grace and not use it as a license to sin. Lord, help us to be holy as you are holy. In the name of Jesus, amen. Hope you have a great Monday.